He's held key positions in state and federal government, and if you're running a statewide campaign as a Democrat, right now he's the gold standard, the guy you want in charge. But now he's taking on a new nonpartisan challenge as the president and CEO of the New Hampshire College and University Council. Mike Vlacich joins us this morning. Mike, thanks for being here.
It's great to be here, Adam. Thank you.
We really appreciate it. Happy Father's Day, by the way.
Thank you. You too.
Thanks. First off, what exactly is the council and what do you guys do there?
Sure. First, I am excited to be here, and I'm very excited to be here on their behalf. We are a consortium of higher education institutions. Actually, we have 21 members. We represent higher education institutions throughout New Hampshire, public and private, small and large. We are their member service provider. We're also an advocate for these institutions, their students, the faculty, administration, and the families that contribute. And one thing that we're, you know, very proud of is the contribution that these institutions make, you know, from White Mountain Community College in the North Country to Riviera University in Nashua, and obviously Keene State in the western part of the state, and University of New Hampshire out in our state's Stafford County Seacoast area. They are not only providing education to over 90,000 students, undergraduate and graduate, in our state. They are contributing to our economy. They're a huge employer. 23,000 people are directly or indirectly employed in this sector. Our members are helping to drive the New Hampshire economy. There's, you know, I believe close to a $6 billion economic impact when you take into account what role they're playing in our state. And so, you know, there's an economic component that I think is critical to our state, and we'll talk about this, I'm sure, this morning. But our state has some, you know, real opportunities for its economy, but some great challenges that face us as our state's demographics change over time. And these institutions, these colleges and universities, private and public, are working together to figure out how we can deal with some of these issues, particularly as it relates to the workforce, as it relates to some of the issues around how to contribute, prepare students as we're entering into college. So we're engaging, obviously, at the higher education level, but also at that K through 12 level.
Mm. One of the challenges definitely has to be on the political side of things. It's become a bit of a hot button issue, at least for funding in Concord. I think everyone can agree, though, that it plays a crucial role, as you're saying, underlying that importance for us, that this is essentially critical infrastructure for the 21st century.
Absolutely. First, on the positive side, if you look at New Hampshire's overall economy, our unemployment rate is among the lowest, if not the lowest, in the nation. But one thing to look at within those numbers is that those who have not completed high school have the highest unemployment rates in the country. They're up around 6.7%. Those that have a bachelor's degree, associate's bachelor's, or advanced degree have the lowest unemployment rates in the state. That's a good news story in that the more degree you have, the more likely you are to be employed. That's a good challenge, and that's something that we have to keep producing more and more graduates. That said, what also happens with lower unemployment is it gets harder and harder for employers to find the necessary workforce to meet the needs. And so we really have to work harder at keeping our students here, attracting more students to New Hampshire, and providing them those higher education degrees. Last week, I was actually at participated in two forums run by the state's business community. One was the Business and Industry of New Hampshire, the other was the New Hampshire High Tech Council. Literally, the first issue raised in each of those sessions, distinct groups, was something related to the workforce. A business person, first question they asked of Senator Hassan, who was at that event, was about what we're doing around workforce. And at the other session, number one priority, greatest need, was how we're dealing with finding the talent to meet our workforce needs. And there's a lot that we are doing, But the reality is that there's a lot more that we need to do. And so obviously investments in our public and private institutions, in our public way, public institutions, what we know is that the community college system and the university system have said that the more investment there is, they have a commitment to using those dollars to reducing costs for students and making college more affordable. And for those in New Hampshire that are attending private institution, the proposals that are out there regarding scholarships might make it more affordable and accessible for students to attend in-state institutions. And that's simply trying to compete with our region, never mind what's happening in the country and around the world. One other point that I think, I think it's important to note is that we actually export the largest number of college-age students out of New Hampshire. And so really, if we were able to retain more of those students and attract more students, but retain our in-state students better, that could help deal with some of the workforce shortage issues, because we are one of the older states in the country. There's opportunities that come with that as well, but it's a challenge. And our region is dealing with that. Northern New England is dealing with that. And so obviously we're going to look at ways in which we can work in a regional capacity as well.
Should the state be focusing on retaining those great students who are coming out of a public high school to try and keep them within our public university and college system? Or should the emphasis be on trying to make sure they stay here once they've graduated and got their degree?
I think in all of the above strategy is what works. One of the things that we partner with the New Hampshire Department of Education on is the New Hampshire Scholars Program. And it's an initiative that is focused on our New Hampshire schools, and it helps prepare students for college so that when they enter, they are able to compete, and it helps with retention rates over time. And that's a good investment. It's not a big investment, and I mean that in the best sense of the word. We make the most with the dollars we have, and we're able to touch every county, almost pretty much every community in the state, or every community that's interested in the state.
Mm-hmm. Student debt obviously remains yes. a big part of this problem. How do you untie that knot in a way that doesn't end up costing taxpayers a lot more money?
Sure. I think again, it's there's a lot of pieces to it. I think the more that we can do to be competitive on the financial aid side, the more that we can be competitive in the investment side from a public standpoint. In New Hampshire, the public institutions, the University System of New Hampshire, actually has the lowest administrative costs in the region. I think that they have heard loud and clear from policymakers that we need to continue to keep an eye on that bottom line, but also still serve the constituents. But at the end of the day, we have to appreciate that if we aren't dealing with this problem, default on these student loans is going to cost taxpayers money too. And so dealing with this in a collective and looking at public investments, there's also a huge education component, helping students and families to be the best consumer possible. One of the things that's happening right now at the federal level that we are looking at and that we're concerned about is, and even though we don't have for-profit colleges here in New Hampshire, the rollback of rules that are being proposed right now at the administration level that would help protect students from for-profit colleges, specifically those that are more predatory, that puts our institutions, we have non-profit private institutions that are providing an affordable quality higher education, and they're really committed less on how to profit off of young people and those attending college, and more on how to provide them a high quality product at a reasonable cost.
All right. Mike Vlacich, President of the College and University Council, we appreciate it. We thank you for your time. Happy Father's Day. And sure, there are a lot of public policy problems to untie here, but you're probably the man for the job.
Well, so. Thank you. And we're excited to keep working for them.
All right. We appreciate it.